Inclisiran, the trade name is Leqvio, is a double-stranded small interfering ribonucleic acid, shortly siRNA. In hepatocytes, inclisiran utilizes the RNA interference mechanism and directs catalytic breakdown of messenger RNA for PCSK9. In its turn, this increases low-density lipoprotein receptor recycling and its expression on the hepatocyte cell surface, which increases low-density lipoprotein cholesterol uptake and lowers low-density lipoprotein cholesterol level in circulation. Let's explain how it works. Low-density lipoproteins carry the hepatic cholesterol to the peripheral tissue. If the low-density lipoprotein cholesterol level increases, it can accumulate in the arterial wall with formation of atherosclerotic plaques. Normally, liver expresses low-density lipoprotein receptor for uptaking low-density lipoproteins from the blood. After the interaction between low-density lipoproteins receptor and lipoproteins, they enter to the cell via endosome. The acidic pH of endosome causes the allosteric dissociation of the receptor and lipoprotein. After dissociation, low-density lipoprotein receptor recycles to the cell surface and can carry other LDL. Whereas low-density lipoprotein is directed to lysosome for degradation, where cholesterol is recovered. Recycling of low-density lipoprotein receptor can be repeated to 150 times. It means one low-density lipoprotein receptor can move inside the hepatocyte approximately 150 low-density lipoproteins. So this way is very efficient. Proprotein convertase subtilisin-caxin-9, or shortly PCSK9. This protein can regulate recycling of low-density lipoprotein receptors. The major sources of circulation PCSK9 are the liver, kidney, and small intestine. PCSK9 is also produced by vascular cells, such as vascular smooth muscle cell, endothelial cell, and at lower level in macrophages. But firstly, let's check the synthesis of PCSK9. According to the central dogma in molecular biology, genetic information flows from DNA to RNA and from RNA to protein. In our case, the PCSK9 gene is located in first chromosome. PCSK9 messenger RNA is formed due to the transcription and splicing processes. PCSK9 protein is a result of translation. Created PCSK9 is secreted into the blood, where it binds to low-density lipoprotein receptor. And now, complex of low-density lipoprotein, low-density lipoprotein receptor, and PCSK9 also enters to the cell via endosome, but in this case, the acidic pH of endosome prevents dissociation of low-density lipoprotein receptor from LDL. As a result, all complex undergoes lysosomal degradation. Therefore, receptor doesn't recycle to the cell surface. That lead to accumulation of huge number of low-density lipoprotein cholesterol in the blood, that in its turn lead to subsequent progression of atherosclerosis. Also, PCSK9 can enhance the degradation of low-density lipoprotein receptor either by a direct intracellular pathway, not requiring its secretion to the blood or extracellular binding the low-density lipoprotein receptor at the cell surface. It leads to lysosomal degradation of receptors too. This way is minor compared to the extracellular interaction. In addition to PCSK9 well-established action of low-density lipoprotein receptor recycling in hepatocytes, PCSK9 can also exert direct effects on atherogenesis in absence of systemic lipid changes that lead to atherosclerotic plaque progression. Another direct effect of PCSK9 is promoting platelet aggregation and activation. Inclisiran is a short interfering ribonucleic acid that binds intracellularly to an RNA-induced silencing complex, or RISC. RISC, in its turn, hybridizes the messenger RNA molecules encoding PCSK9, specifically cleaving the mRNA. The cleaved messenger RNA is degraded to prevent PCSK9 protein synthesis in liver. Thereby, one inclisiran RISC complex can degrade multiple PCSK9 messenger RNAs. Without PCSK9 mRNA, PCSK9 protein does not build it up. As a result, amount of PCSK9 decreases. It means that PCSK9 doesn't interact with low-density lipoprotein receptor extracellularly, doesn't have direct effects to atherosclerotic plaque formation and thrombocyte activation, and also intracellular direct interaction with low-density lipoprotein receptors is prevented. That leads to restoring low-density lipoprotein receptor recycling. Therefore, low-density lipoprotein cholesterol uptaken by hepatocytes with further lysosomal utilization. As a result, blood level of LDL decreases. According to the studies, the level of LDL was decreased by 50% in inclisiran group compared to the placebo group. That in its turn led to prevention of atherosclerotic plaque progression. So, Leqvio or inclisiran is indicated as an adjunct to diet and statin therapy of the treatment of adults with primary hyperlipidemia, including heterozygous familial hypercholesterolemia, and to reduce the LDL cholesterol in case of established atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease or in high-risk population. The recommended dosage is 284 mg, administered as a single subcutaneous injection initially after 3 months and after this every 6 months. The benefits over another PCSK9 inhibitor such as monoclonal antibodies Alirocumab or Evolocumab is less frequently regimen of injections. The most frequent adverse reaction according to the study was injection site reaction, such as pain, erysema or rash. Also arthralgia and bronchitis. If you like the content, press like and subscribe buttons. Have a good day. Here we go.